Work songs. They synchronize complex body motions required for a particular cooperative effort, like a chain gang swinging the 9-pound hammer, or pulling an oar, or marching soldiers, or cheerleading, or playing in an ensemble.
The prettiest girl in Doughboy Town, Doughboy is low. Her name is Fancy Nellie Brown. Oh, my boulevard's slow. Heave a high and let her go. Slow boy is slow. Heave a high and let her flow. Oh, flow, my boulevard's slow.
Work songs have a very practical purpose. They make the job easier and, in some cases, possible. Imagine a Greek war galley rowed by a bunch of uncoordinated rowers. They would be bumping into each other. There would be chaos. The pyramids were probably built with work songs. The Easter Island 80-ton stone faces were probably walked across the island with just ropes and work songs. You can use the work song idea to grow and strengthen your rhythm skills. Check this out. The key to it all is the invisible rhythm, orchestrating everyone's movement. This works both ways. The rhythm can make you move, and conversely, your directed movements can become rhythm as you make music. Your body should be a repository or library of rhythm patterns, rhythms you can access any time you start a performance, so you can lay down the rhythm for the other pickers to follow. Conversely, it may be that the rhythm is given to you and the others by whoever is kicking off the performance. You should be able to tune your body rhythm immediately to match the rest of the pickers in the group. Rhythm is a conduit for the music that comes into you. Rhythm also shapes the music that you project out to the audience. Rhythm is a two-way street. The particular rhythm used in the next clip brings both hands together, working under a central control, and not two independent operators that have to be managed individually. I learned this rhythm listening to the Scruggs version, and I use it to shape my music for this particular performance. That particular rhythm sure won't work for Mule Skinner Blues, but it works for Nashville Blues. Using rhythm this way gives you the feeling that you have all the time you need to go anywhere on the fretboard. Maybe you are a complete klutz. You might even be thinking you can never sound like the pros. Don't let that attitude hold you back. Jump in and get your rhythm fix. You can do it if you understand what's going on with rhythm. But first, you have to break loose your frozen neck, relax and roll those tight shoulders, limber up that stiff spine, unlock those knees and let them wobble. There may be serious klutzy barriers to your sounding like a real banjo player, but you can conquer all if you really want to. It's very physical, my friend. Do whatever it takes. Play along with Earl. Listen to the rhythm. Soak them up. Take dance lessons. Learn Tai Chi. Get drunk and dance.
Dance all night with a bottle in your hand, bottle in your hand, with a bottle in your hand. Dance all night with a bottle in your hand. Good gosh, you might give a fiddle a dram. Bottle in your hand.
You want rhythm? You will have to work for it. Just knowing what makes bluegrass work is only good for conversation. If you want to go somewhere musically, learn to use rhythm as a tool. You can't really go anywhere from here until you can deliver a strong bluegrass rhythm.